use of the action on it, and it release it beforehand with the action on that.
Yes. See, I want to make it very clear that my concern is not that India's image will be damaged and so you shouldn't show the film. I don't agree with our government on that at all. I think that absolutely violence against women is a huge concern for us here in India. We have been talking about it loud and clear. We don't care who does. But my point is that I think that when there is a judicial process ongoing, I have seen the film, and I believe that the film and the manner in which it presents the issues, especially the interview with the one of the accused, is something that will hamper the judicial process and affect the quest for justice of the victim, and it is also unfair to the accused. So I think that to many of the accused, you see, there are more than one accused. And all of this is actually going to play out in the a media trial will end up replacing the judicial trial, which is why we are asking for a postponement of the screening of this film in India. Yes.
Talking to ANI, Nibya's father and mother both emphasized that they do not care whether it is banned or not. All they care about is that punishment or the case should now move forward, and whatever the punishment is given by the court, it should be implemented as fast as possible.
See, I fully sympathize with their sentiments and all of that, but I'm just saying that, look, we do have a judicial process in this country, and this case has actually been fast-tracked. It's moving reasonably fast. You cannot ask for a summary execution. If we are a democratic country, no matter how heinous the perpetrator of a crime, you do not go for a summary execution or for a kangaroo court kind of thing. There is an appeals process. There is a process. One has to go through that. It's very painful for the family and the affected, absolutely. But I don't think that there is any shortcut to this, really. Yes.
Ma'am, a lot of people are angry because they see this as disrespect to the dead, her efforts to save herself. I mean, a lot of people can say that on the downside, this documentary will actually help government to fast-track that case more.
No, I don't. I'm saying that I'm not. My argument is not that Nirbhaya is insulted or any such thing. I've seen the documentary, and I believe that the documentary from beginning to end is deeply anti-women, and it goes against the interests of women, and it has actually not even attempted to understand the concerns and the fight of the Indian women's movement activists who are actually fighting rape and rape culture here in India. Rape culture is a global problem, of course, but I'm saying that even those who are fighting it here in India find that the film has someone, it does not even speak properly. It speaks to me, for instance, but it does not quote large, much of what I have said. It merely uses me as a little prop in the film, just as an Indian face in the film saying something. But it doesn't really talk about my analysis of why rape happens, why rape culture happens, how do we fight.